Mr. Fielder, Bill, here is the first question. Oh, I'm sorry. All right, Bill, you have 2 minutes to give your opening.
Thank you, Carolyn. Thank you, everybody, for being here. Thank Carolyn and Patrick for being here, and both my opposition as well. So my name is Bill Fielder, and I'm running for State Senate District 27. I'm a third-generation Georgian, a true conservative Georgian, a 20-year Forsyth County resident. I am a pro-Trump conservative Republican, and I'm a small businessman. I grew up in Columbus, Georgia, during the time of the Vietnam War, and I came from a very conservative setting, and I've been conservative since, you can't see my hand, but childhood. In addition to being in that conservative setting, my elementary school teacher, principal in the fifth and sixth grade was Mr. Hancock. Can't recall his first name, never was told it actually, and I've tried to Google it, but can't find it. And he was a direct descendant of John Hancock, so he steeped us in traditional values, conservative values, but respect for the flag and patriotism. I've always been in support of the military and veterans. Natural extension of that, the way my dad brought me up, is to be supportive of law enforcement officers and Second Amendment rights. And I hate the idea of an open border or a sanctuary city. I believe that life begins at conception, and I believe in the right to life. And the thing that got me interested in running for State Senate, even though I've never run for office before or ever been appointed in any capacity in a government seat like my opposition has, was RFRA, the Religious Freedom Restoration Act, a straightforward 8-page bill that protects people, places, and organizations from prosecution for refusing to provide service on established religious beliefs. And that is what motivated me to run for State Senate and serve the citizens of Forsyth County. Thank you.
Mr. Tam.
Thank you. Good evening. Thank you for coming tonight. I want to thank the Forsyth County Republican Party for the opportunity to speak tonight. As parts of our state and nation have continued to struggle, we have focused our attention on positioning ourselves as a great place in which to live, work, raise a family, and retire. Our thriving economy, low tax rate, first-class schools, public safety, and award-winning parks and recreation facilities have made Forsyth County a destination for families and businesses. And it is with this reputation that we are presented with both challenges and opportunities. I believe the Gold Dome could use a little more Forsyth County and our brand of bold conservative leadership. I have a record of working for you, not special interests. As your senator, I will continue to fight to protect our quality of life, preserve our heritage, promote private sector job creation, ensure every child has access to a quality education, and tackle the opioid epidemic strangling our families and this community. For too long, Forsyth County has been a victim, resulting in our hard-earned tax dollars being sent to other counties and other regions in the state. I will continue fighting to return those dollars home where we as a community know best how to spend them. While serving on the Board of Commissioners, I championed reducing the millage rate on 3 separate occasions while balancing our county's budget during times of prosperity and throughout the worst recession witnessed by our nation in a generation. I know what it takes to find solutions, navigate complicated government agencies, and deliver results. From the widening of Georgia 400 to securing funding for the Alliance Academy for Innovation, I have a proven and tested record of showing up for work and getting the job done. My name is Brian Tam, and I wish to represent you in the State Senate. I ask for your prayers, your support, and your vote.
Mr. Dolezal.
Hello, everybody. My name is Greg Dolezal. Carolyn, I want to thank you and the Forsyth County Republican Party for having us, Brian and Bill. Thank you all for being here. I'm not sure if you're just hiding from the pollen storm, if you're interested in politics, but thank you for being here tonight. For those of you who don't know me, I'm a Forsyth County businessman and entrepreneur. I have the opportunity of owning multiple businesses here in Forsyth County and working with organizations all around the world. I've worked with Chris Tomlin and Pastor Louis Giglio as the producer for Worship Night in America and Passion Conferences. I started to engage in Forsyth County politics in 2013 when I started Fix Forsyth Traffic. And from there, I went on to fight President Obama's overreach and radical housing policies for coming here to Forsyth County. But tonight is not about my biography. Tonight is about the future of our community. My favorite member of the community is here tonight, Natalie Dolezal. She is my wife of almost 11 years. She is the mother to my three children who are five and under, and we have our fourth on the way. They are the reason that I'm running for state senate. You know, I've talked to many of you here in this room tonight, and you say that it's time for bold conservative leadership. Leaders who stand tall for our values. Leaders who don't crumble in the face of pressure. Leaders who will pull up their sleeves and get to work. I'm going to work to unlock traffic gridlock in Forsyth County. I'm going to work to finally get our kids out of trailers and into classrooms. I'm going to finally eliminate the state income tax right here in Georgia. Can I get an amen? I will keep our community safe by continuing to ban sanctuary cities. I'm going to do all of that, and then I'm going to come home. I'm going to come home because I'm not interested in a career in politics. I am interested in keeping Forsyth County the best place to live, work, and raise a family. My name is Greg Dolezal. I am the conservative that you can count on, and I thank you so much for coming to hear my vision tonight.
And now we'll go to our first question. Thank you, gentlemen. Each one of you will have 1.5 minutes to make a closing statement. And we're going to begin with Greg.
Thank you, Carolyn. Let me close by saying thank you to the Forsyth County Republican Party for hosting this debate, for all of you for being here tonight. It's really, really impressive. I want to thank Brian and Bill for participating. And I know that by working with the men and women in this room, by the way, about half of which have endorsed me, you are my special interest, by the way, we can create a state and county that is stronger than ever before. What you've heard tonight is a stark difference in how we're going to do that. We can turn to a career politician who saddled us with higher taxes, crippling debt, gridlocked roads, and overcrowded schools. Or we can opt for a businessman who's been absent in our quest for the conservative cause. Someone who's voted for Republican one time in a primary in the last 25 years. It didn't help us get Barack Obama out of office. I'm running because I believe you deserve a better option. I'm gonna work to find high-tech, high-paying jobs for our families and children, because as a businessman in Forsyth County, I've done it. I'm gonna continue to lead the fight to allow families to spend more time together and less time in traffic. As an active member of our community, I've done it. I'm gonna work to keep your taxes low and make sure developers pay their fair share. As an effective leader, I've done it. I'm gonna protect our values from liberal overreach, because as a concerned citizen, I've done it. I'm a business owner, I'm a devoted father, I'm a husband, and I'm the conservative that you can count on to get the job done. I would ask for your vote on May 22nd.
Thank you very much, Greg. Bill?
Thank you, Carolyn. Thank you, everyone, for being here. I just want to say, once again, what excited me about doing this was RFRA. I am going to fight for the citizens of Forsyth County. What you have in front of you is a business person who has worked for 4 decades and already brought thousands of jobs through the acquisition, public offering, and help of 3 technology companies in Forsyth Company. It happened before Greg got here, so I guess he doesn't know about it. I also will work for each of you to keep the special interests from getting their hands on money that is meant to come back here and support Forsyth County citizens. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill. Brian?
Thank you. I'd like to thank you for the opportunity tonight. Thank you for coming out, folks. Thank you, Greg and Bill. There's a saying, if it walks like a duck, talks like a duck, chances are it's a duck. If you're funded and supported and endorsed by the special interest of the Sharon Springs Group, you are Sharon Springs. If you want someone who's going to add a new layer of government and 7 new politicians to Forsyth County, I am not your guy. But if you want someone who will unify and represent all of Forsyth County, I am your guy. If you want someone who is tested and ready to go to work on day 1, I am your guy. If you want someone who has proven results, widening Georgia 400, partnering and backing law enforcement, helping businesses succeed, and fighting to return tax dollars to Forsyth County, I am your guy. I have shown I can protect our values, and now more than ever, it's time for the Gold Dome to have a little more Forsyth County under it. For those of you opposed to the city of Sharon Springs, I am your voice. To those of you who support it, I want to be your ear. I have worked before to unite this county on many issues over the years: parks and recreation, transportation, public safety. We've shown we can be united. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Brian. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank the Forsyth County Republican Party for asking me to moderate this debate tonight. I want to thank each and every one of you for following the rules, and I want to thank each of the gentlemen who came out tonight and worked hard to be able to answer the questions that they did not know anything about before they came. And I also want to thank you for behaving like such gentlemen. Thank you very, very much.